AdBlue, or diesel exhaust fluid. What is it all about? How does it work? And what does it mean for people who now want to buy a new diesel, but it comes with an AdBlue system and added cost? Let's have a look. AdBlue is the third generation exhaust treatment, coming after the catalyst, or diesel oxidization catalyst, and the DPF, which is the diesel particulate filter. This is the third generation. It's the next tier to meet these Euro 6 standards. It came out in 2014 for passenger vehicles. A lot of trucks and vans, over 7.5 tons, have been required to use AdBlue since 2004 to meet the Euro 4 and 5 emissions. But this is the first time we're starting to see AdBlue fitted to small passenger cars with diesel engines. New models of the Mitsubishi Triton, some models of the Ford Ranger, and the new Prado 250 series, we're starting to see come out with AdBlue systems fitted. Now, the problem we have with diesel engines is they run very lean, or at least they can do, and they can run well beyond the stoichiometric ratio of air to fuel. And that extra air in the combustion chamber can create nitrous oxides, and they're very bad for the environment, and the catalyst won't deal with them in the exhaust system. And that's where the AdBlue system comes into play, and it's used to convert the nitrous oxides into nitrogen and oxygen, which are completely harmless for us and the environment. Now, firstly in the system, and one of the earliest emissions regulations, is a catalytic converter, or diesel oxidization catalyst. They exist in both petrol and diesel engines, and they are made of platinum. Now, that's the reason why a lot of people like to try and steal catalytic converters from vehicles, is because the platinum is a precious metal and it's worth quite a bit per kilo. The platinum is a catalyst that is used in the reaction but not consumed in the reaction. It is used to convert carbon monoxide and other hydrocarbons that are quite bad for us into carbon dioxide and water. The only thing the catalytic converter can't deal with is nitrous oxides, and that's where the AdBlue system is used. Now, next up in the system, at least for diesel engines, to meet emissions regulations, they use a DPF, or diesel particulate filter. It's basically a fine screen that sits in the exhaust and catches any particulate. Diesel engines, especially when they're running quite rich and you're accelerating, they will produce a lot of particulate, and that is particularly bad for us. So the particulate filter is there to trap any particulates in the exhaust system, and it will burn them off when the car gets hot enough to do so. So if you have a car with a DPF and you use it for towing or long trips where you have high RPM and high speed, you're likely to burn off any of that particulate in the filter either way. Unfortunately, if you're using the car for short trips and it never gets hot, or you're just using it to go to the shop and back every now and then, that diesel particulate filter may actually get blocked. The vehicle will warn you on the dash. It may even go into limp mode and slow down, and it requires to do a regeneration, or a burn, where it gets the exhaust very, very hot. It loads itself up and it will burn any of that particulate out of the DPF. For the most part, if you're driving it quite heavy and you're towing and you're going fast up and down hills, you may never notice the DPF. But if you're taking the car for short trips and it gets blocked, you may need to take it to a dealer or allow the car to do a burn. If the car's doing a burn, it may act erratically. The revs may be sustained at a very high level. There'll likely be a light on the dash telling you what it's doing, and you may notice a hot exhaust smell as well. All of that is normal. It's doing a regenerate or a burn of the DPF. If in any doubt, contact your dealer and they will tell you what's going on, and they may code the car to do a burn for you. So next we move to AdBlue. Now, AdBlue is the third stage of exhaust after treatment, and any car that meets Euro 6 emissions is likely to have an AdBlue system. It's also known as DEF, which is diesel exhaust fluid. It's made up of 67.5% deionized water and 32.5% urea. Now, urea is the same thing we find in urine, but it's usually in concentrations of around 2 to 3%. It's not quite as strong as what we put in AdBlue, or diesel exhaust fluid. The AdBlue, or diesel exhaust fluid, is stored in its own tank in the vehicle, separate to the diesel. The filler is usually next to the filler cap for the diesel, but it is quite a bit smaller and has a very blue cap. The reason the filler is so small is to stop you accidentally filling the AdBlue tank with diesel. The AdBlue is injected into the exhaust after combustion, and that urea, as it heats up in the catalytic converter, it is broken down into ammonia. That ammonia reacts with all the nitrous oxides and converts them into nitrogen and oxygen, which of course are harmless to us and the environment. Most vehicles will use around about 5% AdBlue versus the diesel that they've burnt. So in other words, if we use 100 liters of diesel, we're likely to have gone through 5 liters of AdBlue. Now that is designed in many ways. If we have a tank big enough, we can get to the next service and only fill our AdBlue when we service our vehicles. We also have the option to buy AdBlue from service stations when we fill our diesel. It's much more convenient and it's also much cheaper. We've seen AdBlue per liter from around about $1 to $1.50. But if you buy it from an auto retail store in bulk, you're likely to pay $60 for only 10 liters. Although AdBlue is actually not technically required for the running of the vehicle itself will not operate without an AdBlue tank that is at least filled to the minimum and is functioning properly. The idea behind this is that these vehicles passed emissions testing, they met the Euro 6 standard with the AdBlue tank full and functioning properly. If you run it empty, there is no longer AdBlue going into the exhaust and it no longer meets emissions. What the car will do, it will warn you on the dash, it will say the AdBlue tank is low or it is empty, and it will actually derate the vehicle. It'll restrict you to a certain speed or a certain RPM until you fill the AdBlue tank again. If you turn the vehicle off, it is very likely that vehicle will not start again until you fill that tank with AdBlue. And it has to be AdBlue. You can't fill the tank with water or any other substance. The sensors will pick it up and know that it is not the correct substance for the AdBlue tank, and it will likely derate the vehicle in the same manner it does as if the tank is empty. So what can go wrong and what are the drawbacks? Well, firstly, AdBlue is actually quite corrosive. So you don't want to get it in your eyes or on your skin, and you certainly don't want to get it on the paint of your car or spill it on your carpets. It also crystallizes. So if you spill it anywhere and you leave it for any short period of time and the water evaporates, it will crystallize into like a white fuzz, and it's quite awful and it's very hard to get off. It's also quite costly if anything goes wrong. It's part of the system that's meant to meet emissions, so you don't technically need it. But if it goes wrong, you still have to pay to fix it because your car will not function without it. And that can cost into the thousands of dollars if you need to replace the entire system or any of the tank or the lines or the sensors. It can be a very costly venture. And of course, one other drawback is you are paying for it. Every time you go anywhere, you need to fill the tank with not only diesel, but also you are paying for AdBlue as well. You are paying for that vehicle to meet the emission standards. Now, of course, we're not using anywhere near as much AdBlue as we are diesel, and it's not that costly, but it is something you now have to pay for to keep that vehicle running and meeting those emission standards because you chose to drive a diesel, which is unfortunate if you're a diesel owner. Nowadays, we have catalysts, we have DPFs, we have AdBlue, we have all these emission standards choking up these diesels, but unfortunately, that's the way we need to go if a diesel is going to meet any of these stringent emission standards. For most people, it's a small price to pay and they'll happily pay it. Myself included, if I buy a diesel and it has AdBlue, it's unfortunate, but I still want a diesel. I still like the power and torque delivery, and I still like the efficiency. I still think you'll be way ahead with the diesel over a petrol. It's just one nail in the coffin for diesels. We'll see what comes next.